If you short those two contacts together, that switches the power on. The switch is broken, that the slider part is broken off. You can still operate it with a pointed device, pushing it in and sliding it across, but I should be able to put a remote switch on by just connecting those two leads together. Next, I want to check and see which motor runs from which side of the board. So the motors are marked M1 and M2, M1 minus, M1 plus, M2 minus, M2 plus. So all I've got to do is figure out which is 1 and 2 on the motors. Okay, I've measured the resistance of these wires back to where the motors were. So M1 is the right hand motor looking from the rear. So M2 is the left hand motor looking from the rear. The positive leads are the enameled wire is coloured red, and the negative leads are just gold coloured. So the direction of rotation of these motors, it's an anti-clockwise motor on the left hand side at the rear and a clockwise on the right hand side. So let's see now. By blowing on this, which is the opposite direction of rotation, it's going clockwise. So in fact, it would normally operate that way because the draft comes this way, not that way. And similarly, that one's going anti-clockwise, which means that's a clockwise motor, if that makes sense. Wind comes that way, this one runs clockwise. I'm going to take these two motors and mount them in tractor mode on a sort of wider stance, and then wire in the control board separately. So the control board needs to still be facing forwards and the right way up. So this is front this way, and then I'll wire the motors such that the directions of rotation and the prop directions will be reversed effectively, because the motor was originally that way and now it's going to be over there going the opposite way, if that makes any sense. That's without doing any of the switching of the tractor and normal modes and inverted modes that are available on the board. I'm just going to use the normal mode and change the props and the motor directions as required. I'm also going to remotely mount the battery. It gives me more options of where to fit it, plus it's a lot easier if I can build this into the bodywork without any removable bits. To recharge it, I could take the battery out and charge it separately. I'll put a connector on it, and then a lead with a connector, so that plugs in. Similarly, this broken switch here, I don't need this anymore. What I'll do is I'll mount a remotely mounted switch, which will switch that instead. I'll just solder extend wires for the motors and solder them to the appropriate terminals there. So there's four terminals, and then there's your battery positive, battery negative, and then I need to put the switch across those two contacts there. I'm going to fit these motors where they're supposed to be on the Lightning, the P38 Lightning. The motors will be one each mounted in the front. that's the anti-clockwise motor onto the right hand side of the plane, and the clockwise motor on the left side of the plane. I've modified the propellers by turning them the opposite way around from the original PowerUP 4, so they blow the right direction with the right direction of rotation. It's just a case of filing down the back of them till you get to the hole, because the hole doesn't go all the way through on the standard props, and then mount the propeller backwards, obviously on the right turning direction, and obviously with the right direction of rotation of the motor for the propeller as well. So that propeller goes anti-clockwise and the air goes that way towards the motor. So that's the two motors with their little connectors on. The motors come with these 1.25mm JST connectors. So I just got some mating half leads and soldered them onto the pads on the power-up unit. That's all ready to mount onto the airframe. Switch it on. Need some more nose weight. Whoa! Right.
Take off. Lord, you have landed.
Whoop.